Hello everyone, in this session we are going to learn about negative feedback amplifier characteristics. At the end of this session, students will be able to understand effect of negative feedback on amplifier characteristics and different advantages of negative feedback amplifier. So these are the contents of in this session. So let us go for what are the advantages of negative feedback in short. So with the application of negative feedback in the amplifier, so there are many advantages for amplifier. Like the first gain stability, the overall voltage gain of amplifier with negative feedback becomes stable. So gain stability is the most important advantage of amplifier. And second is the reduced noise non-linear distortion. So with the application of negative feedback, non-linear distortion in the amplifier is reduced. Noise signal in the amplifier is reduced. So bandwidth of the amplifier increases. Whereas the effect of negative feedback, the input and output impedance of the negative feedback amplifier are modified, either increased or decreased as per a requirement or type of feedback used at the input and output side of amplifier. Now let us discuss what are the characteristics of negative feedback amplifier. How the amplifier is able to stabilize the gain, overall gain of amplifier with the use of a negative feedback, the stabilization of gain with negative feedback. The amplifier gain may be affected by the change in surrounding temperature or variation in power supply voltage, or due to variation in different transistor parameters, due to aging of a transistor or a old transistor is replaced by a new transistor. So due to variation of transistor parameters, the operating point or DC operating point or Q point of the amplifier may change. So due to that, the gain of amplifier may change. So with the application of negative feedback, the gain of this negative feedback amplifier becomes stable. So voltage gain with the negative feedback is given by AVF, where AVF stands for voltage gain with feedback. So that is equal to AV upon 1 plus beta into AV. So where AV stands for voltage gain of basic amplifier or internal gain of amplifier. Basic internal gain of amplifier, and AVF stands for overall voltage gain of negative feedback amplifier. So if the product of feedback factor and voltage gain of basic amplifier is much greater than 1, if this product beta into AV is much greater than 1 unity, then the overall voltage gain of amplifier with a negative feedback becomes independent of internal gain of amplifier. If product beta into AV is much greater than 1, so AVF can be approximated to 1 upon beta. So AVF depends upon only beta, that is beta stands for a feedback factor, gain of a feedback circuit. So the gain AVF is independent of internal gain of amplifier and depends on only feedback factor beta. So feedback factor beta, which depends on passive elements used in that feedback circuit, like resistors. So once feedback circuit is designed using certain resistors, their resistance value will not change. So the gain of feedback circuit, that is feedback factor, will not change. So as gain of feedback circuit becomes stable, constant, the overall gain of amplifier with negative feedback becomes stable, a constant. So mostly in feedback circuit, resistors are used. So for resistors, the resistance value are constant once the circuit is designed. So in this way, the overall gain of negative feedback amplifier is stabilized, becomes stable. The second characteristic or effect of negative feedback on amplifier, so it reduces frequency distortion. So with the use of negative feedback, frequency distortion caused in the amplifier is reduced. So as far as negative feedback amplifier is concerned, if product of feedback factor and voltage gain of basic amplifier is much greater than 1, the gain with feedback, the overall voltage gain with feedback, negative feedback, is given as AUF. So that is approximately equal to 1 upon beta. So beta stands for gain of feedback circuit. So overall voltage gain depends upon the gain of feedback circuit, feedback factor. So it shows that if feedback network is purely resistive, if feedback network used in the amplifier is purely resistive, so AVF, that is voltage gain with feedback, becomes independent of a frequency. Independent of frequency, even though the basic amplifier is a frequency dependent. So the gain is totally depends upon feedback factor. So that becomes constant. So once a feedback circuit is designed and it is feedback factor is finalized. So practically, this frequency distortion is caused due to changing the voltage gain of basic amplifier. So frequency distortion is considerably reduced. So frequency distortion is considerably reduced with the use of a negative feedback. So you basically, you know, the frequency distortion is caused due to change in voltage gain of amplifier. So with the use of negative feedback, overall voltage gain of this amplifier becomes independent of the gain of voltage gain of basic amplifier. It depends upon only feedback factor. So the frequency distortion in negative feedback amplifier is reduced. Now next characteristics or effect of negative feedback on a feedback amplifier. So reduction in non-linear harmonic distortion with a negative feedback. So harmonic distortion occurs in the amplifier when transistor goes beyond, the transistor operation goes beyond its range of linear operation. When transistor goes beyond its range of linear operation, this harmonic distortion occurs. If negative feedback is used, the strength of input signal, effective input of amplifier is increased with the use of negative feedback. So by the same factor by which gain is reduced, the factor by which the overall gain of this amplifier is reduced, by the same factor the effective input signal strength of this amplifier is increased. So the magnitude of input signal remains unchanged, and thus there is a reduction in non-linear harmonic distortion. If negative feedback is used and the strength of input signal is increased by the same factor by which gain is reduced, thus magnitude of input signal remains unchanged, and thus there is a reduction in non-linear harmonic distortion. The next, let amplifier basic gain AB produces a distortion D in output signal. If negative feedback is applied, then amplified output signal as well as a distortion is fed back to the input side of amplifier. So let distortion in output is DF in case of overall voltage gain with feedback ABF. A part of beta into DF of this distortion is fed back to the input side of amplifier. So it gets amplified by factor AV and becomes beta into DF into AV. So net distortion in output, amplified output signal, DF, so that is equal to a distortion without feedback minus feedback factor beta multiplied by DF, that is distortion with feedback, multiplied by basic gain of voltage gain of basic amplifier. So the distortion with feedback is equal to D upon 1 plus beta A. So distortion in a negative feedback amplifier is reduced by factor 1 plus beta A or AV. So thus harmonic distortion is reduced by the same factor as the gain. So gain is reduced by factor 1 plus beta A. So distortion is also reduced by the same factor, 1 plus beta A or 1 plus beta AB. Now next characteristic of a feedback amplifier, that is the effect of a negative feedback on an amplifier. So reduction in noise with negative feedback. So noise in amplifier is reduced in the same way as a distortion is reduced with the application of a negative feedback. So it is noise is an unwanted electrical signal with a random frequency and a random amplitude. So that is generated in the amplifier. So the internally due to active device, that is amplifying device like transistors, or it is introduced at any stage of amplifier in the multi-stage amplifier by external source. So this noise can be reduced with the use of a negative feedback if its source of noise signal is lying within the feedback loop. If negative feedback is used with the feedback factor beta, similar to distortion, noise n can be reduced by factor 1 plus beta AB. So noise with feedback NF, designated as NF, is equal to noise without feedback N divided by 1 plus beta AB. So the noise is reduced by factor 1 plus beta AB. So the performance of amplifier is improved. Now last, the effect of negative feedback on amplifier characteristic, that is increased bandwidth, that is improved frequency response. So as we know, the gain of feedback is given as, gain of feedback amplifier is given as AVF equal to AV upon 1 plus beta AV. So, but if product of feedback factor and voltage gain is much greater than 1, then AVF is approximately equal to 1 upon beta. So gain depends on feedback factor. So the main property of feedback amplifier is that it maintains gain bandwidth product constant. So for amplifier, always product of gain and bandwidth remains maintained constant. So with the use of negative feedback, gain reduces by factor 1 plus beta AV. So at the same time, so bandwidth is increased by the same factor. So with the application of negative feedback in the amplifier, the factor by which the gain is reduced by the same factor, the bandwidth of amplifier increases. Now consider this figure. It is a graph of voltage gain versus input signal frequency. So this graph, there are two graphs. One graph of gain versus frequency without feedback, so whose cutoff frequencies are F1 and F2. So this is the difference between F2 and F1 is the bandwidth of amplifier so without feedback, and the bandwidth of amplifier with feedback. So there is another plot or graph, so whose lower cutoff frequency is F1 dash and upper cutoff frequency is F2 dash. So bandwidth of amplifier with negative feedback, so that is a difference between F2 dash and F1 dash measured in hertz. So the bandwidth is increased. So the voltage gain of amplifier is reduced. At the same time, the bandwidth is increased. So with the application of negative feedback, the lower cutoff frequency of amplifier, so that is F1, that reduced by factor 1 plus beta AV. At the same time, the upper cutoff frequency of amplifier F2, so that is increased by factor 1 plus beta AV. So that is designated as F2 dash. So F2 changes to F2 dash and F1 changes to F1 dash. So bandwidth is increased and the gain is decreased. Now student can pause video here and think over this question and try to answer this question. Which type of negative feedback amplifiers are commonly used? So generally, voltage series and voltage shunt feedback amplifiers are used, because voltage series feedback amplifier and voltage shunt feedback amplifier satisfy all desirable features or properties of amplifiers. So most commonly, voltage series and voltage shunt feedback amplifiers are used. So this is a reference. Thank you.